So today we're discussing enterprise architecture in the context of agile organizations. Yeah, you're asking why enterprise architecture is important. All these organizations that think they don't need it because they're agile now. Yeah, that is quite naive. Agile as a way of working, that is just about process agility, having development processes that can respond quickly to change. And of course, that is important. But that still doesn't mean that what you develop is agile. You can pour concrete in an agile way and the end result will not be agile. So next to process agility, you will need system agility as well. And system agility is about designing things that can easily be changed. So that is one important role for architecture. Together, process agility and system agility can give you business agility, and then you can use your agility as a strategic focus and really compete with that. So very important, agile is not just doing Scrum. So the need for agile in architecture, it's really a combination of things that really reinforce each other. It's not about the classical waterfall style of doing architecture. It's really much more about creating things that can easily be changed. And that means that you have to approach architecture in a somewhat different way. And if you look at agile environments, you often see that product owners in Scrum teams are really focused on the functional requirements of single solutions. But you have to have people that take care of the non-functionals, things like performance, scalability, use of standards, regulatory compliance is quite important, strategic direction. So somebody has to take care of that. And that's one of the roles of enterprise architecture. Now, in agile, solution architecture is really the responsibility of the individual agile teams. That's not something the enterprise architecture will do, but architects will provide boundaries on what the individual teams can do to make sure that the solutions they develop fit with the larger scale of the organization. So enterprise architecture helps you translate your business strategy to wider ranging architectural decisions to ensure that every part fits together and that these agile teams don't build their individual agile silos. And unfortunately, I've seen too much of that in practice, where you have this instant legacy built by an agile team, undocumented, not fitting with the rest of the organization. And that is really not what you want. And that's what enterprise architecture can help prevent. In an agile environment, there are lots of reasons to do that and lots of examples to give. It starts with prioritizing on business value. Agile is really about value as well, and enterprise architecture can help you make sure that what you do is traceable to the most important business goals, that you really know why you're developing something and how that contributes to the business of the enterprise. So that helps in deciding on priorities of features and epics and enablers, because they are related to the architecture and you know how things trace back to your strategy. It also helps you plan your work in coherence, because all these different agile teams build stuff that has to fit together. One of the approaches for that is creating a so-called architecture runway that helps you link things together. That is a kind of backbone that you create so that the bits of the individual teams fit to that backbone. It's also helpful in tracking progress. If you can relate the different parts that the different agile teams create to a higher level architecture and see the traceability and, for example, see the impact of delaying a feature to the next sprint, you can also help decide what the priorities need to be, how different users might be impacted by these delays, etc. So that's useful as well. And of course, there's the feedback loop back from the agile teams. It's not just feed forward from architecture to teams, it's also the other way around. Having new insights, innovation, new technologies, feeding back into the architecture from the team level is equally important. One of the key success factors in agile is having these feedback loops. So it's not just from architecture to development, it's also the way around. Yeah, talking about how you do architecture in an agile environment, it is indeed different from the classical style of architecture that we've done in the past, where these waterfalls and handovers and stage gates were implemented to make sure that everybody complied with the architecture. But in an agile context, it's much more a continuous business. Architecture is done in parallel, continuously, next to the development of concrete working solutions, and it gives guidance in that way. And that also means that architects have to be available to convey the vision, the strategy of the company to the Agile team so that you know that they understand what's being done. So it's not just about writing big documents, it's also being available to teams, helping them understand where you want to go as a company. And that means they have to do that in a just-in-time and just-enough manner. You have to provide architectural decisions and guidance at the moment it is needed, not months ahead of time with big documents, but also not too late. So you have to work ahead slightly so that the teams have the material available when they need it, but you don't plan ahead too far into the future because things will be unclear anyway. You don't have the information on the future far ahead, so you would make decisions that wouldn't be right anyway. What's also very important is that you help teams in collaborating amongst each other, because architecture helps define how the bits fit together, what the interfaces between the different components of your solution are, how the different features should fit together. So that's also a very important role of architecture. I've also mentioned prioritization before, deciding on what's important based on where the business wants to go. So helping product management in deciding on the priorities, what do you need to develop, not just in terms of features for end users, but also in terms of laying down this architecture runway, avoiding technical debt that will kill you later on. Those are all architectural aspects that enterprise architects and domain architects can contribute to. And when you're talking to the upper levels of the organization, the C-level, it's providing this line of sight between your strategy and your operations. Where do you want to go as a company, and what do you need to develop to make sure that that really happens? It's not just building some software, it's much more than that. It's about having the right processes in place, developing the right capabilities to ensure that you can really implement your strategy. Yeah, it's not always easy to make this work. The main challenge in getting this up and running is this cultural difference. There are lots of different cultures in organizations, and developers like change. Change is fun. They're into innovation. But users, they often see change as a nuisance. They want to stick to their routines, so they're not always interested in change. People in quality assurance, they think, well, change must be tested. We have to ensure that everything works. So that's their perspective. System administrators, they are not really fond of change because that might affect the stability and continuity of their landscape. So they see change as a risk. Managers really look at it from a time and cost perspective. So change has a deadline and a budget for them, and that's not always in line with how Agile looks at things. And architects, finally, they look at the relationships between the bits. They think change should be coherent. So if different parts of the organization or of the IT landscape are changing, architects look at how can we keep this in check? How can we make sure that this all sticks together? In general, there's this culture clash between the localists, the people from Agile development, DevOps, etc., and the globalists, people looking at the bigger landscape, the strategists, the architects, the portfolio managers. But a focus on business value and close collaboration between these different people to understand each other's perspectives, that is key to overcoming these differences. Now, that's the cultural side of things. There are also lots of technical challenges to make architecture work in an Agile context, because one of the issues is that many organizations are not just developing new software. They have lots of legacy systems or packaged solutions that are not that flexible. So they, one of the things you might want to do is make these more Agile, but that is not easy. These systems are often functionally limited, not very interoperable, difficult to change. So it's quite complicated to make these things more flexible. If they're commercial off-the-shelf systems, then you have to depend on your vendors and their release cycles. Those might be quite long as well. So in an Agile organization, you still might need different speeds of change for different types of systems. Gartner has this bimodal IT vision where you have two speeds. That might be one solution direction, but in practice I see that you might even need more than two speeds, because there is a whole range of different systems with different cycles. And eventually, of course, you want to speed up the slowest systems as well, so your legacy systems eventually also have to get this speedier rhythm, because they are connected to things, say, at the front end that have this higher speed of change. Now, how can you make this all work? The environment is changing ever faster, so becoming more and more agile, becoming an adaptive enterprise is really essential. And it is not just about software development, it is an enterprise-wide issue. You are talking about creating agile processes, creating agile software in an agile way. So having this process and system agility. And architecture is really indispensable for having this sustained agility and not end up with instant legacy because the agile teams just build stuff that works a few months and doesn't fit with other parts of the enterprise. So there's a clearly important role for architects here to build bridges between these different disciplines, create connections between the different parts of the enterprise, and also connecting these different cultures, these localists and globalists, the agile developers, the DevOps engineers, people involved with individual agile teams, and the people looking at it from a more global perspective, from strategy, from architecture, from your entire portfolio. Connecting those bits together, architects can play an important role in that. And in general, focusing on the business value of all these activities, that is the key to overcome the differences between these different cultures. If you all focus on what you contribute, what the value is of what you do, that is the common denominator that helps you really create something like an adaptive enterprise overall.